Everyone, welcome to today's Insta Live, and today we're going to do some burgers. So if you have any questions, fire them away. Today I'm going to be using our barbecue grill. Come and have a look at this. We've got our Swan al fresco. It's powered up. I've got it at 250, all raring to go. So let's start with our first one. So my first burger today is going to be a classic cheeseburger, but I'm going to do it with a twist. I've got some minced beef there, and I'm going to stuff it with a triple cheese. Absolutely amazing. Do a great burger sauce, and it'll be perfect. So here is some nice minced beef. Now, I haven't gone for the really lean stuff. You need to keep that fat in there. The fat will melt away and keep the meat really moist. Don't buy the super lean stuff. I think this is about 12%. So I've got some cream cheese with chives in there. I'm going to add some mozzarella. And I'm going to add some, a little bit of dill. Like so. And I'm going to also put in some jalapenos. Now I like them nice and hot, so I'm going to add the seeds. But if you look at the jalapenos, come and have a look at this. If you look at this membrane around the seeds and around here, that's where the heat is. If you don't want it hot, remove them. Me, I like it hot. I'm going in with a full jalapeno. Just chop it up nice and small, like so. And then I'm going to add that to the cheese and mix it together. So we've got two cheeses. We've got the cream cheese, we've got some mozzarella, and the last cheese is going to be some cheddar, which I'm going to put on top. There's our triple cheeseburger. It's absolutely delicious. Once this center gets hot and it starts to be all gooey and runny and melty, it's really delicious. So there we go. Jalapeno on there. I think that one big one's enough. You can see it's going to have a real nice kick to it. Another great way to do this, if you fancy this and it's not a burger, get a jalapeno, cut it in half, fill it with this cream cheese mix, put a little bit of the mince, press it on top, and grill them as a little canapé. Absolutely delicious. Here's our filling. Go, mix it all together nice. Just going to put a tiniest little bit of salt in there, a little bit of pepper, and that is our cheesy centre, which is going to be absolutely delicious. Right, so my burgers, what's going in the burger? I've got my minced beef, and then here I've got a little bit of oregano, I've got some crispy fried onions, which you can buy these from any supermarket, a little bit of garlic powder, and here's my secret tip. This is a classic OXO cube. Crumble that in, and that gives it a lovely saviness, and you don't need to use any salt. And it gives it a really lovely beefy flavour. I'll let it go in there, and I'll just mix that together. Really simple, and that is an excellent burger. You don't need too many flavours in there. I don't use fresh onion, because you need to cook them out first, otherwise they go a bit watery. I'd use nice crispy onions and they will absorb into the beef and make it a really delicious flavour and texture. There we go, one pack of beef there. Split that in half, this will do two burgers, but I'm gonna then cut them in half again. So we've got four equal size small burgers. Now, how do you get the filling in the centre? I'm gonna shape my burgers nice and flat and thin, that's the key. Get it to the size you need. Like so, that's nice and thin, yeah. And then I'm gonna put in some of my filling in the middle, like so. Then I'm gonna get another burger, nice and thin once again. Make sure it's the same size. Get the edges nice and neat, take your time, no rush. And then that goes on top like so, and press it. And when you lift it up, you're gonna nip these edges together to seal it in. Like so, reshape them. And now you've got that amazing stuffed burger. That was easy, wasn't it? Look at that, beautiful. Stuffing in the middle, it's going to cook perfectly. I'll show you that one more time. make them nice and flat and even. Get the edges good. See how I'm using the plate instead of in my hand? Makes it a lot easier. And just carefully peel that off so it's not stuck to the plate. Get some of my filling in there. Like so. Then I'll get my other burger. It's really good. Really easy. It's like going to the gym, give yourself a good workout. And then got my second burger going on top. Seal the edges up nice with a little crimp. I'm going to keep all the beautiful flavours and juices in and then reshape. Now, that was easy. No tricks. Don't worry about worrying, could I achieve that? You saw how easy that was. That was two amazing burgers done in no time. Now they're going to be absolutely wonderful. You keep an eye on them while I wash my hands. Okay, so we've got the two burgers. What goes with a great burger? Well, we must have a really great burger sauce. So all top burger sauces are made with the following things. You must have gherkin. Please don't miss this out. All I'm gonna do is put this in my blender. A couple of gherkins. You must have in there ketchup. One part ketchup. Mayonnaise, good quality mayonnaise, two parts mayonnaise. And then for savouriness, for colour and for deliciousness, a little bit of American style mustard, not too much, a little squirt. That is it, nice and simple. You hear people calling these secret burger sauces and all these specialty things. Keep it easy, nice and simple. Give a little blitz. Swan mixer there is our beautiful burger sauce. Now that is absolutely delicious. And if you want some texture, what I sometimes do is I cut these nice and small into little squares and I just add some back in for some texture, which I like. Nice and simple. See that? Put some texture in there. Give that a little mix. And there is, honestly, that is the best burger sauce recipe. It's so simple and so easy. That is a must for any barbecue. Right, let us put these on the grill. And while I'm doing that, I'm going to get on with the rest of my preparation for this burger, which is some beautiful pickled onions. And I'm also going to show you how to dress these lovely shredded lettuce with a burger sauce. So let's get it on the grill first. It's going to take about 3 minutes each side. Get them on, and when they're on, you leave them alone. Do not be tempted to move them around. If you move them around, they're going to start sticking and they're going to start breaking apart. Leave them alone. Right. Set myself a timer, 3 minutes, and I'm going to show you how to do some great pickled onions, which are really delicious to go with this dish. So, have you ever seen how I do pickles before on some of my other videos? I keep them really simple. All I pickle things with is lemon juice and a bit of salt. And it comes really clean in the mouth. It's not harsh, it's all natural products. All I've got there is half a lemon. And I'm just gonna put in half a teaspoon of salt. And I'm just gonna slice these onions very finely. Have a look at this. They're just super fine, you see that? They will then change colour when it mixes with that salt and lemon. They'll go a beautiful pinky colour, they'll soften, and they'll be an amazing addition to your burger. Them are nice and fine, like so. Take your time. I'm gonna get them in there. I think one's enough. All I'm doing is just give them a swish around like that. if you have a look in, right in there, you can see how they're all coated in the salt and lemon, and that will be absolutely perfect when it comes to about 5 minutes time. It's going to soften, they're going to get really lovely, they're going to get rid of all that harsh oniony sort of back flavour, and they'll be nice and mellow. So, got my onion, got my sauce. Next thing I'm going to do is my shredded lettuce. So I've got some lovely washed, lovely baby gem lettuce heart here, or you can use cos, or you can use that really retro classic, which is iceberg. Give myself a bowl. And all I'm putting in there is my lettuce. Tiniest bit of salt. A little bit of pepper. And then I'm just going to put a little bit of sauce in here. I'm just going to dress the leaves. All I do, just give it a little swish round. And that will flavour that lettuce and make it really moist. Get some flavour of that burger sauce into the lettuce and just build them layers of flavours up. I mean, you can already see how beautiful it looks. Lovely pink onions. We've got the great lettuce. We're going to have some cheese going on top. And really, all we want next is our beautiful burger and a really nice bun. So today, what I'm doing is I've got some great buns. These are like a soft bun. They're not a brioche. They're more like a pretzel style bun. And they're really good. Oh, there's 3 minutes. Just going to half that. Like so. And go and check on my burgers. Let's come have a look at them. Great. See how they're not falling apart? Look at that. Absolutely beautiful. Take your time, there's no rush. I'm just going to turn that up for a little bit to get a lovely caramelization on at the end. We'll give that another 3 minutes. And that will be perfect. I'm going to set my timer for 3 minutes. There we go. So we've got our buns, we've got our lettuce, cheese and onions. I don't think we need anything more than that for a cheeseburger. You can put tomatoes in, you can put whatever you want, but I don't think you need anything else on that. For me, keep a burger nice and simple. Show off that burger, show off the lovely simple sauce. I'm going to put these burger buns on the grill and I'm going to get them toasted. That's really important, so come have a look. So, I'm just going to toast them. A bit rainy today, but hopefully I'll keep the rain off the bread and the burgers. A bit different to last week. Remember last week how hot it was? Just wanted a little bit brown. Nearly there. Just toast it off. It really adds to the flavour and the texture of your burger when your bun is toasted. Don't use a cold, dry bun. Toast it off, caramelize it, both sides. Gives a lovely texture on the outside, but more importantly, heats it up and makes it delicious. Right. Getting there. Look at that, you can see them toasting nicely. Burger, nice and juicy. It'll take probably another minute. My bun's done. Bring them over here. And I can dress my buns. So, get a little bit of burger sauce on there. Both sides of the lid. And you want some lettuce on there. Like so. And then it's lettuce, it makes a great little side dish as well. A little sauce on the bun. so. And then got my cheese. So what I'm going to do now with my cheese, I'm going to get that cheese nice and hot. I'm going to melt that on my burgers. So because I've got like 30 seconds or so to go, I'm going to get a couple of slices of cheese, put it on the burgers. Cheese in there. I'm going to trust the alarm. And I'm going to give that 1 minute. That'll give enough time for that cheese to melt, and then that will be absolutely perfect. So there's our triple cheeses. Put in my cheddar. Very exciting, this. Keep my board up. And then I'm going to show you a next burger, what I'm going to do. So this is all about this mince. Now this is lamb. So what I'm gonna do with that lamb is I'm gonna make it like a Turkish style flavors. I've got a load of spices going in there. I've got cinnamon, cumin, coriander, chili flakes, oregano, garlic, and paprika. All them spices are going in there. That's gonna make it really aromatic. I'm gonna serve it with some crumbled feta. That's going to go in there. I've got some beautiful San Marzan tomatoes I'm going to slice up, and I'm going to show you a really lovely pickled cucumber with chili and dill. And then to finish it, it's going to be a yogurt which has garlic, dill and lemon. And I'm going to then put a little bit of chili. I'm going to serve it with these great buns I saw today. I thought, oh, do it like that. So I'm going to do it a bit more like a kofta style longer, split it in half, and it'll look a bit like a hot dog. So that's what I'm going to do with that. Let's get these cheeseburgers out, see where we're at. There we go. Now, how good do they look?
Mmm.
Yeah. Put my two cheeseburgers in there. If you look inside there, look. See how that cheese is all melting inside there, look at that. It's all cooked, it's all hot. It's all delicious. So I'm gonna lift my burgers onto there. Like so. I'm gonna put my pickled onions. Now look how they've gone pinky and all soft and beautiful. Lovely mound of pickled onions on top of there. Put a little bit more lettuce, and there is perfect cheeseburgers. Look at that. Now if you got a cheeseburger like that at a party or a barbecue, you're going home happy. Look at the height of them. Triple cheeseburgers, pickled onions, special sauce, dressed lettuce. Absolutely perfect. You keep an eye on them while I wash my hands, and we will move on to the next one. How good do they look, everyone? Put these just there out of the way, and you can drool over them while I'm making the next one. Move my sauce. Get my bowl a little cleaned down. And then we move on to the Turkish one. So, absolutely wonderful. Here's my minced lamb, like I said earlier. This is also, again, don't buy the stuff that's not got enough fat in it. You need the fat. It's really important to cook it with the fat. The fat will drain away and it'll keep it really moist. In there, I'm going in with all my spices. Look at that, it's gonna be so delicious. I'm not putting any salt in there. I'm just gonna put a little bit of pepper. Like so. And I'm going to just mix all that together. And you can see the meat changing colour. And that meat is so fragrant now. I wish you could smell it. You can see the colours dispersing through it evenly. That's going to give it an amazing, amazing taste colour. Now, we'll probably get what? Probably get two generous ones out of this. So what I'm going to do with this is shape it the bun is. That's about right, I think. If you imagine, it's a bit like a kofta kebab. If I did it round, it would be like a classic burger. So don't worry if you can't get these buns. If you just want to get a normal burger bun, that'll be absolutely fine. It'll still work out exactly the same. So there we go. Here's my two. You keep an eye on them, I'll wash my hands again. I will now show you my yogurt dressing. Really simple, couldn't be simpler. I've got yogurt, got a clove of garlic. Don't use too much garlic, it'll be fiery if you use too much. I'm only going to put in half a clove. That's enough. You see that? You don't need a lot. If you use too much, it will be fiery and you'll get that burning sensation that you don't want in your throat from raw garlic. What will help that rawness is a little squeeze of lemon juice that will help neutralize it. Little touch of salt, like so. I'm going to put a load of beautiful fresh dill. Here's my gorgeous garlic yogurt with dill. That is a must for any sort of Greek, Turkish, Mediterranean style burgers. Very fresh, very light. Better than using mayonnaise on this occasion. Here's my salad, I'm gonna go with it. But while I do the salad, I'm gonna get these on to cook. So follow me to the grill and we'll get these on. Turn it down a little bit. There we go. We're going to sit happy there. We're going to give that for, let's give that 2 minutes. We'll have a look and we'll turn it. It doesn't take long. People overcook food. You want that food to be cooked and hot and safe. But you don't want it well done so it loses all its gorgeous flavours and juice. Pickled cucumber is a must for this burger for me. And it's very similar to how we did the onions. Just got a cucumber there. I'm just going to very finely slice the cucumber. Like so. Take your time. How thin they are, that's how we want them. Don't cut your fingers off when you do this, do it nice and slow. If you can't chop fast, make sure your knife is nice and sharp. There we go. Got a cucumber in there, got a fresh lemon in there, and of course we need our salt in there. I'm gonna put some chili flakes because it goes really lovely with this cucumber. A bit of pepper. And some more of that gorgeous fragrant dill. Get herbs in your food, they're so good for you. It's really important, you'll find dill everywhere. If you can't find dill, use some coriander. Use some parsley, but just start playing with flavours and getting them in there. Now they're a bit firm at the moment, but they will do their magic like it did with the onions. In fact, the onions you could put in there as well, they would be delicious. But that will go perfect. We've got our sauce, we've got our cucumber. Next, we're going to do our tomatoes. And all I'm going to do with the tomatoes is just slice them nice and fine. Here's my little alarm. Like so, spread them out, and what tomatoes like before you eat them is they love a little bit of salt nice and early. They love seasoning, it'll get all the juices gone and it will get the flavour of the tomatoes really beautiful. So a little bit of salt, a little bit of pepper, and we'll go and check our burgers to see if they need turning. Lovely.
So I've kept them with the bars going that way, and very simple, once you loosen them off, like so, just turn it like that, just rotate it. See how I just did that? Make sure it's nice and loose. Now just rotate it, yeah? I'm going to do that 2 minutes, and then the last one 2 minutes.
Easy. That one goes on for 2 minutes. And now, I'm going to show you how to do some really gorgeous crispy fried onions to go with this for topping. What I've got here is some shallots. Just going to slice them up finely, like so. And this is a French style crispy onion. And in here I have some milk. And all I'm going to do is put them in the milk. I'll do one more. There we go. Put some in the milk and let them sit a little bit. I've got some seasoned flour. Oops. My alarm. Keep an eye on that. That's nothing like a proper live or something that go wrong. Anyway, we're not burning down, we're all good. So back to where we were. We've got some shallots. And in here I've got some flour, some garlic and some paprika. There you go. From the milk into the flour. Get a nice coating. Like so. And I do a double dip on this. Go back in, take all the excess flour off, like so, into the milk, that's my alarm, perfect, back into the flour, right, I'll give my hands a wash, you keep an eye on them, and then we'll turn the burgers. Right, let's turn this for the last time.
Absolutely delicious. That's what set my smoke alarm off.
Mm.
That's okay. No problems. Nice. Right, my crispy onions are here. They're going into my fryer. And all I'm going to do is, once they're all coated nicely, double dredged, get them a nice coating. Just going to drop them into the fryer carefully. And this makes just the most amazing crispy garnish, which is a must for any burger, but they'll be particularly good with this lamb. You also make a great little snack if you're just having a little glass of wine or a beer. Best to use a fryer. If you haven't got one, get yourself a fryer. This is my lovely Swan fryer. Keep an eye on them frying. There we go. Just give them a little stir around. You can smell them, they smell amazing. Once they go really crispy, I'll take them out, let them drain. A little bit longer. You see them changing colour? Look at that. Nearly ready, a little bit longer. And all I've got is a bowl with a little bit of dish paper just to take the excess fat away. Let them drip dry and then there'll be a lovely crispy finish. That's them done now. tip them out, give them a little bit of salt, and look at them. They're delicious. Now, get my bun, and like I showed you with the other buns, we're going to give this a gentle toast. I'm just going to split that down the middle. Like so. Just open it a little bit, not too much, I don't want it falling apart. And I'm going to put these buns on and take my Turkish burgers off. That's been done perfectly. Look at that. Gorgeous golden brown. Carefully lift them. Like so. Give the bun a nice toast. This brioche really likes it to be softened up. And when it gets a bit of heat, it softens lovely. Seconds, 20 seconds. Another one. And away we go. Perfect. Switch that off. And let's build this last burger. So, I've got beautiful bun like that. It's toasted, it's warm, it's opened up, it's got a great texture. I'm going to put in first a little bit of chili sauce. Like so. I'm going to put in some of my gorgeous tomatoes that are full of flavour now. Gonna go in with my gorgeous, moist, beautiful lamb. Look at that. This is a special one, this. And I'm gonna go in with some feta cheese crumbled. That's a lovely bit of saltiness to it. Like so, give my hands a clean. Pickled cucumber's perfect and soft now. A little bit of pickled cucumber. The colours, I mean, look at that. And I'm gonna go in, dollop some gorgeous sauce on that. Like yogurt sauce. There we go. Finish off with a little bit more chili. Because it's not hot, but I want that lovely aromatic flavours going through. And finally, my lovely crispy onions. Now if that's not two of the best burgers you've ever seen, we're going to be doing something wrong there. Get your barbecue lit up. I want you to try these recipes because they're terrific. We've got a triple cheeseburger stuffed with jalapeno cream cheese and mozzarella. We've got some gorgeous burger sauce, pickled onions and dressed lettuce. We have a Turkish style lamb with pickled cucumber, tomatoes, garlic yogurt, feta and crispy onions. Thank you very much. Sorry about the alarm. This is live. These things happen. Nothing went wrong. The best thing that's going to happen now is we are going to eat this for our lunch. Have a great day and we'll see you next time. Thank you. Bye bye.